See this image. It's an ultra-diffused galaxy, Dragonfly 44. A galaxy with a nominal amount of visible matter. Dragonfly 44 contains only 1% visible matter compared to the Milky Way galaxy, and it's almost half its size. Considering that, astronomers calculated the mass of this galaxy. The result was unbelievable. The mass of the galaxy was almost equal to the Milky Way galaxy. It's difficult to believe that 99% mass of the whole galaxy is invisible. Dragonfly 44 is a part of Coma Cluster. Surprisingly, the visible mass of the whole cluster is only 10% of the total mass. In fact, according to scientists, only 15% mass of the whole universe is visible, and remaining 85% is invisible. This invisible mass is called dark matter. Today in this video, we will be talking about the dark matter and the connection of dark matter with the concept of God. Hello everyone, my name is Aditya and welcome back to my YouTube channel, Sky Map. In 1933, a Swiss astronomer, Fritz Zwicky, observed a unique mass problem in Coma Cluster. He saw the existing visible mass of the whole cluster was too low to gravitationally lock more than 1,000 galaxies in the cluster. This cluster needed 100 times more mass to lock these galaxies within. This was the first clue of dark matter. The second clue came from the findings of two American astronomers, Vera Rubin and William Kent Ford. To understand their findings, you need to recall the concept of gravity. In our solar system, we rotate around the Sun. The nearest planet feels the highest gravity of the Sun, and the farthest one feels the lowest. It's just the Newton's inverse square law from our 9th or 10th standard physics book. The gravitational force decreases with the increasing distance. So, our Earth orbits the Sun at much higher speed than the farthest planet, Neptune. Using the same logic, two astronomers studied the stars' movement around galaxies, especially the Milky Way and Andromeda galaxy. The result that they expected was like this. With the increasing distance from the galactic core, the stars should slow down. But their observation was totally opposite. The stars were speeding up with the increasing distance from the core. This was very peculiar. There can be only one solution of this problem. We calculated the mass of these galaxies totally wrong. There must be a huge amount of invisible matter at the galactic center, which is responsible for this unusual speed of this star at the outer edge of these galaxies. This invisible matter of concerning mass was named dark matter. So there is a huge amount of dark matter present in our galaxy. In fact, the amount of dark matter present in Milky Way is much higher than our neighbor galaxy Andromeda. But what is dark matter? There are many videos and articles on internet that claim we have solved the puzzles of dark matter. But sadly, these are completely wrong. There is only one single piece of information that we know about dark matter. That is, there is an invisible matter in our universe that reacts with gravity. It can bend the space-time fabric. Unfortunately, dark matter doesn't react with anything other than gravity. It doesn't emit light. It doesn't react with electromagnetism. In fact, it doesn't even take part in great collisions. Many countries and space organizations have conducted multiple experiments and observations to detect dark matter. But till today, they have found nothing. Just nothing. Scientists believe that dark matter is made up of small particles called WIMPs, just like electron, proton and neutrons are made up of quarks. However, the concept behind it is totally fictional. It means the whole mass of the universe is divided into two parts, 15% visible matter or baryonic matter and 85% invisible matter or dark matter. It is the dark matter in our universe that holds the main structure of galaxies. If we look closely, our universe is made up of dark matter cosmic web called filaments. This cosmic web is like the skeleton of our universe, and our galaxies are just the skin upon the skeleton. But how do scientists find these invisible particles? There are mainly three ways to detect dark matter: galaxy movement, X-ray emission, and gravitational lensing. First, let's talk about galaxy movements. As we discussed earlier, in the Coma cluster, visible matter can't explain the movement of galaxies. According to our mathematical calculation, a huge amount of mass is missing in this galaxy cluster, which is binding these thousands of galaxies gravitationally. Another such galaxy cluster is Bullet cluster, almost 3.7 billion light years away. Similarly, scientists think more than 85% of this galaxy cluster is made up of dark matter. The second way of detecting dark matter is X-ray emission. Let's take the example of Bullet cluster. According to scientists, the gas clouds of this cluster are under much higher gravitational pressure than the visible matter can produce. As dark matter reacts with gravity, it can easily influence the gas clouds to accumulate, and this accumulated hot pressurized gas emits X-ray. You will be surprised to know that some astronomers think the strong X-ray source in the center of our Milky Way galaxy is due to dark matter. On the other hand, some suggest it is due to pulsars and neutron stars. What do you think about this matter? Please write down your thoughts in the comment section. The third and most interesting way to detect dark matter is gravitational lensing, predicted by Sir Albert Einstein. We all know light travels in a straight line, but in space, when light travels through a high mass object like galaxy or galaxy cluster, the traveling path bends. According to Sir Albert Einstein, it happens because our space is four-dimensional and the fourth dimension is time. Due to the high mass of galaxies and galaxy clusters, the time slows down and the space itself bends. So the light doesn't bend. It's actually the light's traveling path, the space, which bends. That's why we see it in this way. Gravitational lensing helps us study distant objects situated behind a galaxy or a galaxy cluster. During calculations, scientists have found the bending of the light is not equivalent to the visible mass that they can observe. So dark matter is carrying the mass which is bending the light and creating this lensing effect. To know in detail about four-dimensional space, I highly request you to see this video where we have talked about black holes and space-time curve in detail. I think we all know about the famous mass-energy equation, E is equal to mc square, where E is energy, m is mass, and c is the speed of light. So, mass and energy are interchangeable. We usually see space and matter from mass perspective. But if we think in a different way, like if we calculate the mass and energy both together, then the baryonic matter and dark matter together contains only 1/3 of the whole universe. 2/3 of the universe is made up of dark energy. This energy is responsible for the expansion of space at a speed greater than the speed of light. If you want to know more about dark energy, please write down in the comment section. I'll make a separate video on this topic. So, we can only see 5% of our huge universe. The remaining 95% of the universe is totally unknown to us. Many people connect this 95% world with the concept of God, because we don't know how this unknown world is helping our existence. If someone says life is possible on Earth just because dark energy and dark matter exist, then there is no way to prove it wrong. When we don't know anything about something, then many ideas can arise. In fact, there are many hypotheses that are very popular, just because no one can prove them wrong. So, we can't say that dark matter and dark energy are not connected with God until science finds some concrete evidence. What do you think about this topic? Please write down your thoughts in the comment section. If you found this cosmic journey fascinating, then I think you will also like this video, where we have unveiled the mysteries of black hole, where the space and time doesn't exist. You will also like this one, where we have talked about the destruction of Earth and the end of humanity. At last, please don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and share it with your friends and family members, and subscribe for more space related content. And remember, keep looking up, stay curious, and explore the mysteries of the night sky.